Number 13, the logic of dreams. In sleep, our nervous system is perpetually excited by numerous inner occurrences. Nearly all the organs are disjointed in a state of activity. The blood runs its turbulent course. The position of the sleeper causes pressure on certain limbs. His coverings influence his sensations in various ways. The stomach digests, and by its movement, it disturbs other organs. The intestines writhe. The position of the head occasions unaccustomed play for muscles. The feet, unshod, not pressing upon the floor with the soles, occasion of the feeling of the unaccustomed just as does the different clothing of the whole body. All this, according to its daily change in extent, excites by its extraordinariness the entire system to the very functions of the brain, and thus there are 100 occasions for the spirit to be surprised and to seek for the reasons of this excitation. The dream, however, is a seeking and representing of the causes of those excited sensations, that is, of the supposed causes. A person who, for instance, binds his feet with two straps will perhaps dream that two serpents are coiling round his feet. This is the first hypothesis. Then a belief, with an accompanying mental picture and interpretation. These serpents must be the cause of those sensations, which I, the sleeper, experience. So decides the mind of the sleeper. The immediate past, so disclosed, becomes to him the present through his excited imagination. Thus, everyone from experience knows how quickly the dreamer weaves into his dream of a loud sound that he hears, such that the ringing bells or the firing of cannons are such to explain from afterwards, so that he thinks he experiences the producing circumstances that sound. But how does it happen that the mind of the dreamer is always so mistaken, while the same mind is awake, accustomed to be so temperate, careful, and skeptical when regards to its hypothesis, so that the first random hypothesis for the explanation of a feeling suffices for him to be immediately in its truth? For in dreaming we believe that the dream is if it were reality, we think our hypothesis is completely proved. I hold that as a man, now it's still reasons and dreams, so men have so when awake through thousands of years, that the first cause which occurs to the mind which explains anything required an explanation was sufficient and sold for truth. Thus, according to travelers' tales, savages will do this very day. This ancient element is human nature still manifests itself in our dreams, for the foundation upon which higher reason has developed and still develops in every individual. The dream carries us back into remote conditions of human culture and provides a ready means of understanding the banner. Dream thinking is now so easy, it's because during immense period of human development, we have been so drilled in the form of fantastic and true explanation by the means of the first agreeable notion. Insofar, dreaming is a recreation from the brain, by which day has the tired demands of the thought. As they will down in higher culture, we have drawn it to discern the reality practice and awakened state that the door in the known of a dream. We show our eyes, the brain shows impressive lights and color. It's part of the pilot day, echoes of all the light of cover and cover by day. Now, however, the understanding together with the imagination imaginably works the color shapeless in itself into definite figure form, landing in animated groups. The actual and accompanying process is again kind of conclusion from the effect of the cause, since the mind asks where once comes the impression of light and color. It supposes the figures and forms as a cause, it takes for the origin of the colors and lights, because in the daytime we open eyes to some divine producing cause for every color, every effect of light. Here for this one, for the boy with the boom system, top down, and see with the coolest system. When he come up in the club, he be blazing up, because sex and dance, like he's saving up, and he really, really might get a bill. Papa calls in the garth rank a bill. He tall, he dopey, my so cool, he old, and they're about another coach. From these circumstances, we make a highly more acute, logical thing, the discrimination of cause and effect has been developed. When our reasoning and understanding I felt like a steel and hark back to the primitive force of deduction, and when we pass about half life and both to the artist assigned for and losing calls with no amazing truth, and when the ecological coordinate writes to understanding of it.